Hey, on today's episode, I'm gonna take another really super good classic. It's famous in a lot of the Italian restaurants. What is it? Chicken Alfredo. Not just ordinary chicken Alfredo. I'm gonna do it for under 10 bucks. But what makes this one really super good, the fact being your kids, of all people, are gonna be crying for more. Mommy, Daddy, make me more. Trust me, this recipe is one you're gonna wanna watch. You're watching Crazy Dave's Kitchen. Welcome back to Crazy Dave's Kitchen. So, we're talking about the chicken Alfredo here. What are some of the ingredients? Well, I've got some chicken breast over in my grill. I smoked it for about 4 hours on my Traeger. Now I'm gonna actually finish it off and I'm gonna grill that. Now that's gonna be something I'm gonna show you in 1 second here, because when I'm done, I've gotta dice it up. So, you know, whatever chicken you wanna use, you know, 3, 4, 5 breasts, depending on how much chicken you like in chicken Alfredo. But what I got over here is a jar of chicken broth, a couple cans of chicken broth, a bottle of heavy whipping cream, and some fettuccine noodles. Simple, basic ingredients. Now what we're gonna do first is we're gonna take the chicken broth, we're gonna put it into a pot, we're gonna bring that to a boil, then we're gonna add the fettuccine noodles into the broth and let it boil with the noodle. Do not drain these noodles. Let them cook in the chicken broth. That is one of the big, huge secrets on chicken Alfredo. Stay tuned and I'll walk you through step by step. The first thing I did is I added the chicken broth into the pot. Okay, let it come to a boil. Now, as it is kind of almost boiling here, I am gonna add the chicken noodles to that, okay? So we might wanna zoom in here a little bit and look at the chicken broth. You see that it's kind of boiling away. Take the fettuccine noodles, open them up here, and just break them, doesn't matter. You know, if you can break them. You know, a little bit at a time, whatever. And just put them into the pot. Now notice I'm gonna get a lot of complaints from Italians. What are you doing breaking the noodles? No, trust me, break the noodles, it doesn't matter. Pause. So as you can see, right now it's not really boiling, it's just simmering, but I got it on high. Come back every couple of minutes and give it a good stir. Stir frequently, because you don't want the cream to burn on the bottom. So just give it a few, you know, a little bit of stir every so often. And again, we're gonna keep doing this every couple minutes or so until it actually starts to boil. Okay, so as you can see, the cream is a little on the boil, starting to boil a little bit. So now, I'm gonna take the 2 cups of cheese and just dump it in. And we're gonna start stirring and mix it up really super good. Now you notice, it's starting to melt on the back of the spoon. That's okay. You wanna keep stirring it until the cheese is melted. So this is the time you just keep stirring it. Keep the heat on high for right now, because we want the cheese to melt really super good. Okay, so as we can see, 2 cups of shredded Parmesan didn't really give the effect that I wanted. So I'm just gonna add, you know, another 2 cups of Parmesan here. So this is actually about 4 cups of Parmesan cheese. And again, we're just gonna mix it up and keep mixing it until the cheese is all melted. Okay, so the sauce is pretty much creamy, the cheese is melted. I'm gonna add some cornstarch to that, okay? And I'm just gonna add, you know, maybe good tablespoons here of cornstarch, okay? We're gonna add a little bit of water to it, we're gonna mix it up, and we're gonna throw it into the pot. Okay, so now we got the cornstarch all mixed up, and we're gonna pour it into the pot. Okay, let it sit for a little bit. Then we're gonna turn the heat down to low, which we did already. And we're gonna start slowly mixing the pot. Now eventually what's gonna happen is it's really thin right now. And what the cool thing about cornstarch is it thickens up really fast. And it's gonna make it really hard for me to stir this stuff. And this is where the magic happens. So keep stirring it until it gets really super, super thick. But make sure your heat is on low. Okay, so right now, as you can see, the cream sauce got really kind of thickened up a little bit. Look at that. Nice and super creamy. So about this time, I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna add some fresh cloves of garlic. Now with the garlic, what I like to do is I like to crush it, but before I crushed it, I actually took the whole clove and I actually smoked it in my Traeger. And I'm gonna go ahead and put it into a fresh garlic press and add it into the pot of the chicken Alfredo. Okay, so what I did now is I turned the heat off and I'm letting this kind of chill out a little bit. Now, as it chills out, you'll see that it's starting to get real super, super thick. And that's what you wanna do. Now, if you notice, I have not added the chicken yet. Right now, the chicken's on the grill cooking. And once that's done, then I'm gonna dice up the chicken and I'm gonna add it into this mix. So, I took the chicken off the grill, I diced it up, I put it into the pot. Now what I do is I put it into some containers. The reason why I do that is actually, believe it or not, this chicken Alfredo tastes better when it's cold. So what I like to do is pack it up in these little tiny containers here, and I send it to work with my wife, or send it to school with my daughter, or we just come home and we nibble on it all night long as a little quick snack. Well, thanks for watching Crazy Days Kitchen, and this is how you make chicken Alfredo.